stream is going to be fantastic because then you're going to be able to use it even if you're not familiar with coding, even if you don't know how to code, even if you're not very familiar with Azure. I will show you how to make all of that work. And so we're going to be building a Twitter logic app that then checks for new tweets based on any hashtag that we want, and then have it go directly to a Discord channel. That's going to be fun. So let's get started. Here we go. Ba-bam. We're going to make an Azure Logic app. Here's how you do it. All you got to do is you go to the portal. So portal.azure.com, and then you log in, and then you go to the portal, you search for a logic app, and then you say, add a logic app, comfy tweets. We go to hosting, and Azure Storage is fine. And the plan is going to be workflow standard. Yeah, that's okay. And when the plan size, yeah, this will be fine. And so we apply, and then monitoring deployment in progress. Ba-bam. Good job. You're done. We're done. Well, there you go. There's the entire Azure sponsor segment of the day. I'm just kidding. We're going to actually have it hook up to all the Twitter accounts and things. And so we're going to click the stateful one. And then we'll say the workflow name is going to be Twitter Monitor Crate. This is really fast. If you just search for a tweet, this is the one that we're going to search for. Look, look, look. There's a Twitter one. When a new tweet is posted. Kabam. We're going to create a connection. This is going to be InstaFluff Tweet. Oh, I could create my own Twitter application if I want, but I think the shared default application is fine. And then I sign in, and I'm gonna have to sign in with my Twitter account. I could make a logic app that knows when I tweet something, like a new content, and then have it go directly into a Discord channel. That's pretty useful. Let's see if it works. Like, we can do from at InstaFluff TV, and then we can test if we have a tweet. Right now it's just a trigger, and then we have to add an action to it. We have connectors here. The one that we're gonna look for is Discord. Oh look, Discord. And here's the actions. You can execute webhook, you can get a current user, get current user guilds, user connections. We just need the webhook. I'm gonna create a channel inside our own Discord. Azure Logic App tweets. The text channel, yes. All right, select the server. The comfy corner, and then we'll add webhook too. So I'm gonna go here, I'm gonna create webhook. I have to go to annotations and then view webhooks. Would you look at that? Well, I'll create a new webhook. And so, wha-bam! The other end part of this is the webhook token that goes after this. Like it goes ba 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 bam. Like all of that stuff. And it's like a giant long string. Finally, I go here. Okay, the content is gonna be the actual tweet text. There it is, profile image URL. And then, use that. And then, all right. There we go. All right, so we got the execute webhook, and this is super simple, right? All it is just like when a new tweet is posted, execute webhook, and then you just save it. Right now, the key thing is that it checks every minute for a new tweet. And so I think it's time to actually test this out. This is where supposedly if I post a new tweet, then now that we hooked it all up and everything, it's going to show up here anytime I post a new tweet. So this is a test tweet using an Azure Logic App. Should I run? Oh, would you look at that? This is the test tweet. Wow, that was fast. This is really neat. Okay, let me see. What else can we do? I guess we can just make another one. Bitcoin tweets. Okay, we're gonna make another Logic App. We're gonna create a tweet one. Maybe we can just even make other ones too. This would be neat. We're gonna do, let's check for Bitcoin tweets. This will be very interesting. Every 30 seconds, it's going to check for a new tweet about Bitcoin. All right, so I go to the integrations. I go here. Here's Captain Hook. Copy the web URL. I'm going to save this out into a notepad on the side. Where's my notepad? Come here. Perfect. Here's the Discord channel. And then I got the webhook ID. Avatar, why not? Bam. The content is going to be the tweet text. And then the username is going to be tweeted by. All right, I put in the token and then I save it. I'm gonna try just running this trigger. I wonder if this works. Oh, it worked. Oh, holy crap. Whoa, Bitcoin, BTC, there's something in French. What a beautiful day of our communication. Oh, I feel like this Twitter thing has so much potential, but I don't know what else it could do. There's even like different triggers. Maybe we can even just start over and make a new trigger. Can I delete this one and then add a completely different trigger? Oh look, I can. This is pretty nice. What should we do? Choose an operation. Wait a minute. I want to search for, would you look at that, Animal Crossing DLC. That would be a good one, right? I think. So we could search for the term Animal Crossing DLC like this and do maybe every every 30 seconds when a new tweet is posted, yes, I can add an action and then have that go to, I bet you could even send emails to yourself. Create an email address for add subscriber, create list, bench for email, convert, click send. You can send text messages to yourself anytime that happens. Send email, look, you can send email. You delete email, get email details, move email to trash. Wow. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back to the Discord thingy here. We're gonna add a Discord channel action. Okay, and I could do execute webhook. All right, this sounds pretty good. And then I have it saved. And do content, username, avatar URL. All right, so the content is going to be tweet text. And the next one is going to be username is going to be, there we go. So when a new tweet is posted about Animal Crossing DLC, then we should see them in this channel, but we could also theoretically put it into our Animal Crossing channel, except that's just gonna spam it, and so we probably don't want it there. But did it save? It saved. Let's see if this works. Oh, look, there is one. There's a new tweet that says, retweet, Rose of Battle, happy Home Paradise DLC giveaway. I'm streaming the Animal Crossing DLC now, picking one winner in an hour, so come on. Da-da-da-da-da. It works, y'all. Man, this is so easy. And there's ways to format it and stuff so that we don't have to worry about doing all this stuff. But this is neat. There's no code. We did not write a single line of code today to do all of these things. When a new tweet is posted and it executes the webhook and it executes the Discord webhook and you just create it, you just go bam 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 bam, and then you go here and then you're like integrations, and then you do this and then you get the webhook. And when you get the webhook, then I can show you how you get it. So you copy the webhook URL. This first part right here, that is the webhook ID. That's the one that you put into here, webhook ID. And then the second part, although all of this other second part here, is what you put into the webhook token here. And then you set the content and username, et cetera, et cetera. And then you save it, and then you've done it, and then you're done. And then you run it, and you're good to go. And then if you don't want to have it keep processing and charging new money for it or whatever eventually, because I think it'll keep running otherwise. Here we go. Delete webhook. And so now it's clean. And then I'll go back here and go to config tweet monitor. I'll go here and then I can delete this app and delete deployment. It's going to delete the Logic app. That's how you clean it up.